All right, joining us on tonight's Big Get, we have Ryan Edwards, sports extraordinaire for KOA Radio. Ryan, we are finally talking about game week, but first, the big news of the day, Emmanuel Sanders returning to the Mile High City to retire a Bronco. Just your first reaction on his press conference today and, you know, what he meant to Broncos country, because he's going to be remembered for a very long time.
Oh, no, he definitely is. I'd say, I mean, his toughness, right? I mean, that's one of the first things you think about is how many times that he just laid out for the ball, and he put himself in harm's way, and he still came away with it. And obviously, that is a signature thing about him. He talked today in his press conference how he's 5'11", 175. You know, players use all sorts of things to motivate themselves, but that's clearly something for Emmanuel. He wanted to make sure that his legacy was, hey, I could play on the outside. I'm not just a slot receiver. And he certainly, when he got here to the Denver Broncos, he showed that, and they put up some extraordinary numbers. And you think about when he got here, the Broncos were already the best offense in the NFL the previous season, but there was something that he brought to this team that did eventually get them over the hump. I honestly have said for many years that Emmanuel Sanders was one of the more underrated signings for John Elway, especially in that offseason when they brought in DeMarcus Ware and they brought in Aqib Talib and they brought in TJ Ward. Emmanuel Sanders was just tremendous in his time here.
You know, he was part of such a great era of Broncos football. We have another one beginning Monday night in Seattle, whether it be Russell Wilson or Nathaniel Hackett. As we get ready to really start ramping up and focusing on this game, Ryan, I wonder what excites you the most? I mean, we've waited so long for football. What's getting you out of bed these days in the morning?
Yeah, well, I mean, definitely football, for sure. It's exciting to talk about real football. You know, I'd say that the biggest thing that I'm really interested in this one, of course, is the storyline with Russ returning to Seattle. I want to see what the offense and even, I guess, to a certain extent, the starting defense look like, because, you know, we didn't see him in the preseason. And so there's a lot of really fun kind of angles on this thing. Nathaniel Hackett coaching in his very first game. I know he saw him in the preseason, but it's just still not the same. It's a road game. It's going to be a tough environment. It's prime time. There's all sorts of fun things in this one. But, yeah, I mean, first and foremost, Russell Wilson going back, playing his former team. Who has the edge? Is it Russell Wilson because he's still considered one of the elite quarterbacks? Or is it Pete Carroll, who knows that quarterback better than anybody else? I can't wait to watch it.
And you know Pete Carroll's been studying film and getting his defense ready for a very long time. I mean, Russell signed with Denver, what was it, 6 months ago? Can you remember another time that there was this much excitement and buildup to week one where we really haven't seen anything?
It's hard to imagine. I mean, Peyton Manning, right? I mean, that's the furthest way. But you're right. We haven't seen any of the preseason games. It's only if you've been out to practice, it's the only time you've ever seen Russell Wilson throwing the football for the Broncos. So, yeah, I'm with you on that. There's this sort of cloud of secrecy on it, even though it's not really secret, right? I mean, it's like, okay, what are they going to look like? Is it going to be a running team? Is it going to be a heavy defense, right? I mean, we expect upgrades on the defensive line, and the secondary still looks really good. And maybe Jonas Griffith is going to be back for this game. Yeah. So there's all sorts of really cool things. We just don't know what their identity really is going to be. And we keep coming back to, well, Russ wants to cook. Well, you still got a really good running game there with Javonte Williams and Melvin Gordon. We know that Cortland Sutton was wide receiver one. So like I said, the identity of this team is a little bit of a mystery even to this point.
We've got a couple weeks, or a couple days, I should say, of practice, having had today off. Is there anything in particular, Ryan, you're looking for as we get ready to start talking about this football game? I mean, Nathaniel Hackett said yesterday he hasn't really started even installing the game plan yet.
Yeah, I thought that was kind of interesting, right? And again, you know, you take what coaches and GMs and everybody say in the public sphere with a certain grain of salt. But I think the point that he makes is a valid one, because he doesn't want it to get stale, right? He doesn't want, okay, well, we know what we're going to do, and we've known this for weeks now, and you're sort of resting on the fact that we've kind of gone over and over and over and over it. And then you get it paralysis by analysis at that point. He wants it to be fresh. He wants these guys to be amped about it. Plus, coaches are creatures of habit. And what's important to them is, hey, we are in the process of building what is going to be our week-to-week plan and prep. So, again, he wants this week to be like any other week. Don't want to treat it as anything different. But, again, we in the media, the fans, we all know it's way different than that.
And, Ryan, we were talking before we started rolling here that the tickets for that Monday Night Showdown are now the week one most expensive in the league. We're not surprised, but we're a little biased here. But as far as your listeners, have you noticed any kind of interest in the other side of the homecoming, you know, reuniting with Shelby Harris, Drew Locke, Noah Fant? Any interest there?
There would be. Yeah, there would be if Drew was playing. Yeah. I mean, I think with Shelby, he was a fan favorite. Everybody's excited to see Shelby. You just don't want him to play well in this game, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Same thing with Noah Fant, right? I mean, Noah Fant was a first-round pick. He was a guy that I think Broncos fans expected to be a cornerstone player on offense for years to come. Well, and now he's a Seattle Seahawk. So hopefully when Bradley Chubb goes up against him in the pass rush, he struggles maybe a little bit. We'll see. But, yeah, I mean, I think if Drew Locke was playing in this one, it would certainly have a little bit more flair on that part of it, at least for Broncos fans.
That Lumen Field, we know in Seattle, is one of the loudest venues in the NFL. There was an article in ESPN today which kind of diffused the thought that Russell Wilson really kind of pushed his way out. Instead, it highlighted the fact that maybe the Seahawks really didn't treat him well, and that's kind of what led to that souring relationship. Do you think that may lessen the tone, the atmosphere of booing Russell Wilson, where, you know, I understand that the wound is still fresh and he left 6 months ago, but maybe there won't be as many people, you know, screaming at him and you know, ushering those negative thoughts as he hits the field?
Hey, that's a really positive spin on it, Aaron. I appreciate you for trying, but they are 100% going to boo this guy. They have spent all of their energy up there in Seattle telling everybody that he left us. He quit right on us. And I guarantee, and you even saw right when he was traded, the immediate notice from the owners, from ownership, right, from ownership, from GM to down to coach, they all said he quit on us. We right wanted to keep him. He wanted to be out of here. So they've been running that PR campaign this entire time. No, he's going to 100% get booed. And I think the bigger question becomes, do they do any kind of tribute to him? Right? I mean, we saw Peyton Manning when he went back to Indy. He got a tribute video. Tom Brady, when he went back to Foxborough, he got a tribute video. It's the first game since he's been traded. So I don't know. I don't know if they're going to do anything special for him. But, yeah, I guarantee he's going to get booed.
It certainly feels like this is their Super Bowl in week one, which should be a lot of fun for all of us. All right, prediction time. Ryan, who wins this game? And give me a final score.
Oh, well, I think the Broncos are just the better team overall. If Russ can manage his emotions, and that's going to be the big question here, because Peyton could not. Peyton really struggled in that game in Indianapolis when he first went back, and they lost that game. And there was some other reasons around that, but yeah, they lost that game. So if Russ can manage his emotions in this one, if he can stay kind of within the construction of what the offense is, if the defense can pick him up at times and special teams doesn't make mistakes, yeah, I think the Broncos can win this pretty easily. I think they're the better team. So I put it around 28 to, I'd say, 21, something along those lines. I think it's going to be a one-score game. But the Broncos will cover, and that's what's important.
Well, if that is the case, that's going to be a great way to kick off Monday Night Football for the season. All right, Ryan Edwards, thanks for joining us once again on tonight's Big Get.